Welcome back. You're with the Morning News. Time now for a look at what's happening around America with our U.S. correspondent, Dan Sutton. Good morning here from Dan. Now, after what's happened in Japan, understandably, there are a lot of questions both here and in the U.S. about the future of nuclear power.
Tash, the United States has 104 nuclear reactors and there are already plans for them to build another 20 or so. And understandably, after what's happened in Japan, there's been a lot of discussion and debate about nuclear safety in this country. The president has been a big supporter of nuclear power. He says it's green and he's just given a new interview about it. Here's a little of what he had to say this morning.
I think that we've got to look at all potential energy sources. The nuclear facilities that we have here are closely monitored. We have an independent regulatory agency, the Nuclear Regulatory Commission, that examines how our nuclear plants operates, thinks through all eventualities. Obviously, all energy sources have their downsides. I mean, we saw that with the Gulf spill last summer.
Meanwhile, Tash, no matter how bad things seem to get in Japan, the authorities here say there is very little risk of any radiation moving across the Pacific and hitting the island of Hawaii or the west coast of the US. And unlike China and France, the US has not been warning its citizens in the Tokyo area about the need to get out. They say they fully back the handling of the disaster by Japanese officials, and any Americans who are in Japan should follow their lead.
Dan, on to other news out of the US today. There's been a second deadly bus crash in New York in just a few days.
Tash, it was just a few days ago we heard about a bus crash in New York that killed 15 people. Well, sadly, there's been another one just a few days later. This tour bus was on its way to New York. It actually happened in New Jersey. And this serious accident, according to witnesses, happened when the bus veered off the freeway and smashed into an overpass support. Now, two people died, the driver of the bus and also a passenger. Several other people were injured in this crash as well. So it's under investigation. At the same time, we're hearing a little more about the driver involved in this crash a few days ago. Now, he claimed he had to swerve to avoid hitting a truck. It's now emerged this driver has an appalling criminal record with convictions for manslaughter and also for theft. The police investigation into that crash is now focusing squarely on him.
Now, Dan, a new hiccup for the US space program.
Sure is, Tash. The Kennedy Space Center is where the final two shuttle launches will occur, and it's also where the Space Shuttle Discovery recently took off from. Authorities have now revealed they've found over 100 grams of a white powder at the facility, which has tested positive to being cocaine. More than just a personal quantity, this is an amount police say could be held by a drug dealer. So it's not very good news for NASA as all eyes are on it ahead of the final two space launches. Tash.
And Dan, finally this morning, I know you are so thrilled about this next story, so excited to talk about Justin Bieber because you're his number one fan. A couple of honours today for Justin Bieber and also a couple of other very well-known musicians. Tell us, I can see you so excited.
Yeah, thanks so much, Tash. Well, we might talk about the two who I am fans of first. Some big honours and some inductees to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Neil Diamond has been inducted at a lavish ceremony in New York overnight, along with Alice Cooper. It was a pretty big bash overnight. A lot of people attended. Diamond had flown in from Australia for the ceremony. He said he was just glad they did it while he was still alive. The 69-year-old then sang one of his best-known songs. The daughter of a president was the person that that song was written about, Caroline Kennedy. Tash. Now, you mentioned Justin Bieber. I know you're a bigger fan than me. And if you thought there was not enough Justin Bieber around, well, throw a couple more into the mix. Unveiled today in New York, a wax sculpture of Justin Bieber. There he is, looking pretty suave. And in fact, if you thought that wasn't enough, there's another one that's been unveiled in Amsterdam, as well as another wax sculpture of the pint-sized model in London. Here he is. He walks in and poses next to it. I don't know if you can notice the differences in hair. He used to have a long haircut. Now it's a little bit shorter. A very exciting day for Justin Bieber fans everywhere.
Because of his music, his personality, his hair, his style. He's just amazing in so many ways.
I don't know how you can get so excited about someone with great hair, Tash.
I've heard you can do this fringe thing very well. Anyway, thanks so much, Daniel Sutton, joining us there from the US.